What's going on, guys? I tied up a fly because I've been tying and fishing saltwater a lot lately, and I've been doing some research on different things for Fluke, and I came across this cool little pattern that Steve Ferrara tied up, and it's this little baby Fluke here. And when I posted it on Facebook, a lot of guys asked to have a tie-up video. So today we're going to be tying a baby Fluke by Steve Ferrer. Slightly different design to it than he uses. Just a slightly different thing. On a one-aught jig hook by Umpqua. So let's get into it. Let's tie it up. I'll see you down at the vise.
All right, here we go. So the hook we're going to be using is a jig 60 degree. It's by Umpqua. So this is it right here. It's a heavy wire hook. Okay, that's what we're gonna be using. So that's that. For the eyes, we're gonna be using Living Color eyes, 5mm. This is from Fish Skull. For the weight, we're gonna be using 0.030 lead wire. And the main ingredients to the whole damn fly is the mirror image H2O right here. Okay, and it's in, I believe, natural belly color. So this is it right here. And then you're gonna need a little marker, either brown, or this is actually sepia. Brown color marker. I really like using this for flies. And a black Sharpie. Okay, so here we go. We're gonna start off with cutting our lead. Just use an old pair of scissors and just cut yourself 4 pieces of lead. I already have them pre-cut, 0.10 in clear. They also make it in black. So we're just gonna start our mono right here, because this is right where we're gonna put lead. We're just gonna put a little base down, just so it grabs a little bit and doesn't slide on us. All right, 4 pieces of lead, and you need them about how big are these? About a half of the shank of the hook here. I'm gonna put one on each side of the shank here. And this is gonna make the fly ride true. So we have our 2 on each side of the shank here. And then we're gonna put 2 right on top of the 2. However, closer to the shank. So you're kind of making like almost like a V on top. I'm just gonna put one secure one down, and then I'm gonna put the one next to it. So there it is, okay. So basically what you have here is you have 1 piece of lead here, and then you have another piece on top. All right, with that lead covered up, and then just a zap-a-gap really fuses your mono to everything. So makes it really durable, and it just, like I said, it fuses, just makes that plastic melt right into everything and just come together. Just stay back when you're applying this, don't be on top of it. Otherwise, your eyes will burn a little bit. So we're gonna get on there, let that dry a little bit, and we're gonna work our way back with the mono. We're gonna take it all the way to the bend of the hook, past the barb, because we want our tail to be right here. So Steve started to fly here and worked his way forward. I started in front, work it back, and then work it forward. Reason is because he had the tungsten. So if you do locate that video, on the YouTubes, you'll see how he tied it. All right, so this is the stuff right here. If it gets really fuzzy on you, just get your hand a little wet and it won't be as staticky. And we're gonna take a piece out. We're gonna actually cut out all our pieces. So when you're doing it, I always measure it to the stoutness of the hook. So with this particular hook, this is the width. I'm gonna get about 4 or 5 of these ready, just so we're moving through it and we don't have to constantly cut it. So I'm gonna do about a hook length of a tail here. The shank. Okay, and I'm just gonna do right one on top. This is the only one you're gonna be tying slightly different. Everything is gonna be different. Okay, so I have it secured. There it is. And then I'm just gonna bring this right over the top, just like so. Okay, make sure you pinch it with your fingers right here. All right, and then you're just gonna bring your mono right over the top of it. And you're gonna secure it. 1, 2, 3. I usually do 3 or 4 wraps, and you're gonna advance your thread, okay? So now that you have this here, you just cut off your tail right there. So there's your tail. When you do your first section, you're gonna go right in front of this bump, and you're actually gonna put it on the side of the shank and not the top or the bottom. And just do 3 securing wraps just to secure it. And now you could adjust it where you need it. And as you could see, this one's on top of the shank and this one's on the side. The length doesn't really matter on these stacks because you're gonna be trimming it anyway. So just get it there. If you can't get a good wrap, just spin it clockwise and your thread will get a little tighter and it'll stay exactly where it was. It's a little trick I learned. All right, there it is. Get nice and tight, and then you're just gonna secure this whole bundle down. This way, if a bluefish picks this up off the bottom, you're not losing half your fibers, and it's nice and tight, okay? So now, I'm just gonna, since I know which one's which, I'm gonna cut it the same length as the other one, okay? So there it is. So the first lay, I cut the second one the same way. Now don't worry about it the way it looks now, it's okay, because we are gonna be trimming it. So now, if you notice, your tail's on top of the hook shank, your section's on this side of the hook shank. Now we're gonna come to this side of the hook shank, and we're gonna go in front of the bump that we created on the other side, so you're staggering it. So now, if you look at it here, if you notice your tail's right here, this one is stacked here, and the stack closer to me is stacked towards me more. So each time you're going in front of the bundle, so you're gonna have a little bit of a gap. So our next one is gonna get tied in right there. Okay, so you just interlap back and forth until you get it done. So I'm gonna go through this really quick. All right, so now that we have the sections all the way to the lid, I'm gonna separate these fibers a little bit, spread them out. What that's gonna allow me to do is spread the glue right down the middle. We're just gonna gently brush it down just to secure all of the mono and the fibers that are close to the shank. All right, and then we'll flip it and do the same thing down the shank here. This will make it more durable in the middle as well. And back to fast forward. So there's your setup. Do a quick whip finish or a half hitch, whichever one you prefer. There's that. And one more, just so nothing slides. All right, there it is. Now, I'm gonna apply some Zappa Gap on this front where we put the whip finish, because I want to seal it. I'm also gonna take the glue and hit the top of the fly here a little bit and allow that to dry. So just gonna take your scissors and you're gonna slowly start trimming away. Now if you ever look at a juvenile fluke swimming around, they're not very proportional. And even Steve mentioned it in his video. Sometimes one side's bigger than the other. So if you don't get the perfect trim, don't sweat it. Now, bottom gotta get really secured. I want to make it very durable on the bottom. I'm going to be using loon cure. So if you don't have loon and you have something else, start out with a very thin viscosity of your UV resin. And you want to coat every piece of that lead and then some fibers. So if you see me, I'm actually laying it out, squirting it in there, and just spreading it out a little bit. And then I'm gonna hit it with the UV light. And coat, and we're gonna get that in there, get it all flowing throughout the bottom of this belly, because like I said, this thing's gonna be riding. So that's in there. We're gonna hit that with the UV. It's thick, really hard to come out. There's only a little bit left. I gotta get a new bottle. And any holes, any spaces you had when you were putting the material down, you could fill in now with your thick. Okay, and you also wanna put that thick towards the front here, right there, because this is gonna be your bump. This is gonna be riding in the dirt against the shells, and you want that to be durable. You want it to last at least a couple dozen casts. Usually, all right, that's done. Okay, now you're gonna take your marker, brown or sepia, and you're gonna color the crap out of this. Okay. So I'm going to flip the flyer around so you could see. There it is, okay. So now it's brown and you have that solid bottom. That's not going to go nowhere. The thing I'm going to change here, I'm going to change this profile to a more rounder in the front. And more rounder here. Now we're going to lay the black dots on top. If you want to make them darker, you can make them darker. If you want to make them lighter, you can make them lighter. If you notice, mine are all slightly different. This one's a little on the light side. This one's super light. This is the one we just tied up. And I make them darker too. A little variety is good to have. So now we're just going to put it back in the vise to put the eyes on. I'm going to drop a little bit of this super glue just to hold the eyes in place. Okay. Just a couple of dabs, and then I'm going to drop the 5 mils on there. To be honest with you, I don't think the eyes make a difference, but we're going for that look. So why not go for that glue, for that look? Be careful, don't super glue your fingers together, and do not super glue the eyes to your fingers. I almost did, because we're gonna hit it with a UV thin. The flow, and that's gonna secure. It's like UV glue. So there are the eyes. They're gonna get hit with the light. And these are a little crooked. It's okay if they're a little crooked. They're more on one side of the head or the body, which Fluke normally have it like that. And to be honest with you, it really doesn't matter. And then we're going to hit it with a little bit of thin. Just finish it off with the thick. Alright. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a good big thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this on saltwater flies or any other pattern you might want to see, let me know, leave a comment, and there's your baby Fluke.